Gateway Gamers Podcast.
Hi, welcome to the Gateway Gamers Podcast. I'm Bryan.
And I'm RP.
And this is a podcast where a veteran like me introduces the world of gaming to a noob.
Like me.
Hello, welcome to Gateway Gamers, special episode, crossover with the previously recorded.
Ayo, this is the episode that we promised you.
Yep, not as drunk as I would have liked, but we're getting there.
So I am special guest RP, and the co-host today is Bob and Shane, my co-host of previously recorded. They're the Gateway Gamer co-host today.
Don't forget the producer, Nick.
Yeah, producer Nick is also
next year as well.
If he chimes up anything.
He picks and chooses when he wants to talk, but when he does.
It's gold.
You're in for it.
If any previous recorded episodes recorded in the weekend, you will hear I get asked a question, then it's 20 minutes of someone else talking, and then the question gets passed on.
Nick, you don't have to eat the microphone when you talk into it.
Nick, you've been on this podcast before. You need to really fight to get your answers.
He has been on Gateway Gamers before.
He's been on Gateway Gamers before.
No, I said he has. This is special.
This is what we're dealing with, folks.
Did you guys like tease that we were going to do this?
Yeah.
We talked about our retreat. I
don't listen to your podcast.
That's fine. I don't listen to yours.
I do religiously. I just wanted to reiterate what you said. Yeah. If you could explain what you said, like I was five, that'd be great.
Talk about retreat, coming up with ideas.
Yeah.
We have a notepad with one page of
ideas,
crayon scribbles, and
well, we had a tiny little notepad, and then we
upgrade it.
Yeah, we risked the elements.
Yeah, brave the elements of Ocean
icy.
City, New Jersey to go to Acme.
We walked one whole half a block.
It was icy, though.
The general store was closed.
I felt a lot.
Mm-hmm.
Then we went to Acme and McDonald's.
Which is when it lets in, because we didn't have masks.
Yeah.
Which is our fault.
Them. It's our fault.
Because there's
them.
A pandemic.
Yeah,
mask up. That's on us.
That's kind of what we've been up to. If you follow our social, you see we have a giant mountain of games. We've probably played three.
And a giant mountain of beers.
Yeah.
We did play one game.
We've played three for a total of 6 hours.
Yeah.
Just long games.
We did play one game, and it was through a third burrito.
That's right. Third Third Burrito.
How about a segue?
Yeah, that was impressive. That's why he's my co-host. Yeah, so Third Third Burrito was the surprise hit of the weekend so far. I mean,
I wanted to die after playing Betrayal on the Hill. So yes.
It's a card game where you get to peg shit at your friends. So what do you want?
So Third Third Burrito is the same makers as
Exploding Kittens.
Bob's on point today. Look at him.
He did his research.
Yeah.
Hot seat RP right now.
He's coming for your
he's
job.
He's watching his job disappear.
We had the conversation earlier, and Marvel seemed to be like...
Bob's coming for your job.
Having a brain fart, so I was just filling in.
So,
You guys act like I don't play games, too.
Wait till RP finishes that call.
That's the whole bit. Like, the whole thing is that RP doesn't have, the gaming background.
Mm-hmm.
I have
you
more
have
of a
bit
gaming
more.
Background than RP does, which is why me being on Gateway Gamers isn't as appealing. Because he's the newcomer.
So it's more like art, like Marvel's showing RP.
It's like
games.
It's the apprenticeship. If
you listen to
the first 6 minutes of an episode, you would know that.
The intro.
Just listen to the intro. When he said, "I don't play games, but that's a pretty good podcast." So clearly, your cards are showing there. Jeez.
I've played Exploding Kittens with Marvel and other people a bunch. Like, I've played a bunch of the games.
We did used to play that game. That's a good game, too.
When I was on the Mashup episode.
And we played
Smash Up. That was not the first time I played Smash Up. So, me knowing Exploding Kittens isn't like, oh, my God.
It was impressive you knew the company, because I was blanking.
We talked about it earlier. That, I saw you blanking. We'd already had that conversation earlier.
So,
Throw Burrito
is a card game that also turns into a type of dodgeball game. The point is to win two rounds, basically. And how you achieve that is there's no turns. Everyone's given 15 cards. There's a bunch of weird animals. If you played Exploded Kittens, it's kind of the same thing. There's licking chicken.
Non-stop.
Chicken. Emo, sloth, weird animals. And then there's also these cards that are either...
Brawl, or war.
Yeah, so if you get... three licking chickens, you throw it down in front of you, that's a point. But if you get any of these special cards
basically
that activate a brawl.
Yeah.
So if you get duel, you pick two people, they stand back to back as if they're gunslingers. They walk 3 paces, turn around, throw the burrito.
They both have the burrito in their hands when they do that,
So they turn around, try to hit each other, and whoever hits the person, they get a little chit and that's one less point at the end of the round. All six chits are gone. That's the end of the round. Whoever has the most points with the cards in front of them, because every matching three you get is 1 point, and if you throw a matching three of the special cards, it's 2 points. And that's pretty much it.
That's the basis. So duel was back-to-back. That was like the calmest, to be honest.
Yeah, that was a breath of fresh air.
You pick two people and like, all right, it's RP, Shane, you're going to go. The calmest
until we're chasing each other down the hallway.
Oh, yeah, now and then you're throwing. And then we found out that we were staying on top of like a furniture store. Like, I'm sure at 11 a.m. this morning, they thought that we were bigger degenerates than we were. Like, if they'd come up and just seen a bunch of grown-ups
playing this game.
We're just playing throw burrito.
Holding a foam burrito. Like,
rolling under a table to avoid a hit.
So then the other one, Brawl, was whoever drew the, like, played the Brawl cards, person to the left, person to the right, it was just reaction. Whoever grabbed the burrito, you had to hit the other person.
Basically, if you were always up against RP like I was, just take the loss.
Take the L.
Because you're not beating him.
You were getting smacked in
he's
the
too,
eye.
He's too quick. Yeah. He's too quick. And he grabs the burrito every time, either way. And sometimes it benefits and sometimes it doesn't.
It's true.
And then the war card was anybody but the person who played it is, like, fair game.
Yeah.
And it was just, there's two burritos, so it was just like first person to get hit gets the token. We actually extended it, so like we played it out.
It was like a last man standing.
So, like, even if the first person got hit got the token, but everybody else just kept playing, and like whoever the last man standing was won that section. But you didn't win anything. It was just like, it was anticlimactic if somebody got hit right away, because the war card was like exciting.
It's just fun to peg each other.
Yeah, it was a really good game.
We played, four rounds?
Yeah,
rounds?
We played for a while.
Yeah, we were sweaty. It was just like, it got really hot all of a sudden after
turn
running
the AC
around.
Fans.
We were diving behind couches, run up the halls. It was fun. Like, I'm surprised how much I like that game.
So, Shane, from a person who doesn't game, you seem to be really enthralled by this game. You really enjoyed to play it. Would this open you to play more games, or do you think this is like a one-off kind of thing?
No, absolutely would open me to play more. That and the second part of this episode, what was that game called?
Betrayal at the House on Haunted Hill.
I was really into that one.
I was shocked.
I
was into
it. I actually was surprised.
I'm hoping we play some Harry Potter Clue later, because I'll get super into that also.
That's a standard.
Those games don't get covered on here.
Harry Potter Clue doesn't come out until 1 a.m. anyway.
If more board games let me peg my friends with foam burritos, I would be a part of this podcast.
You can peg me whenever you want.
Sleep, and we were playing Harry Potter Clue that one.
No, because that was the hot wing.
It was the hot wing.
She ate so much hot wings and drank so much milk.
So we played.
She is pissed. Yeah.
We played. She had the chills. We played Harry Potter Clue like a few times
for 6 hours in a row.
And then it was like 1 a.m. We're like, all right, one more game, and it went an hour and a half, and it was like 3:30 in the morning.
Christine was like sleeping on the couch, waiting to take she was driving
from the hot wing. She drank about a gallon of milk.
Yeah, she had one. Bite of one of the wings that wasn't one of the hot ones. And then she couldn't handle anything else. She drank about 7 cups of milk.
Then she had the chills.
Then she was eating
sherbet
because we didn't have sorbet.
RP thought sorbet and sherbet were the same thing,
which is better.
Are they not?
Palate cleanser.
Which is the best. Yeah, so like sorbet is different. And RP goes,
I don't know how different, though.
Yeah. I don't know either, but
I think you could get more sherbet. That's
RP
why you got
said,
it.
I got rainbow sherbet
as
a palate cleanser.
It did work.
It didn't have sorbet, so I just got rainbow sherbet.
It was cold on your tongue. It felt good.
But so she ate probably half of that.
Yeah, and then she just went to sleep.
And then she had her jacket on inside the house and just went to sleep on the couch.
If that entices you in any way, shape, or form, we do have a Would You Rather and Hot Sauces episode on Previously Recorded. Go check it out.
If you want to listen to people chew wings, go check it out.
I did my best to.
It's a lot of chewing.
It was a bad.
Producer Nick edit out.
That
stuff.
Was what episode like
hot wings. Pretty early on.
It was like 15.
That was the only episode that RP's dad was on.
It made so much sense in our heads.
We all died,
and then we didn't think so about hot. The fact that you had to listen to us chew wings.
Disgusting. Yeah. So Nick, you're also in the same boat as Shane. Not very much gamer. Would this open up for you, or is this a game that like you're like, okay, I don't need to play anything more?
I think this was more we played. I would say more of a one
and done.
To like if to say to try to sell you on all.
Yeah, yeah.
It's definitely, I would say,
it's a good
different, but it was really enjoyable.
Yeah.
I would like to see. I know we used a table that was kind of longer.
It was not proportionate to the amount of people that we had, for sure.
I was shocked at kind of strategy you had to kind of put into the game. Like, If you, depending on who you play to get, like, next to was really make or break, because the speed they put cards, like, you, like, RP, was flying cards. Like, and then I would turn to Shades, and it's like, they're like, wait, waiting for another card.
Well, plus, RP was killing me with the burrito, but then I was also just pegging the shit out of Bob, which eventually I felt bad. Just because you were always right to my left. It's the easiest throw.
Like, I'm used to it. My parents do it.
Like, one round, I thought Bob was... I'm just giving him points. Like,
well, that's...
So, I don't think we said it.
Yeah,
so
it's an aspect we can talk about.
You have to... You have your 15-card draw pile, and you have to have 5 cards in your hand. And then you just discard, but your discard pile is the person next to you's draw pile.
Yeah.
So, like, however fast you discard, and then it becomes just not like a
there's no turns. It's just going.
Yeah, but it's not like an organized pile. It becomes literally just like a mass of cards
in front of you,
picking whatever you grab out of that. And so, like, the faster, like, I would be like, it would just become just a shuffled amount of cards. And then I would see Nick put one down, and Nick had been feeding me gold because he obviously was looking for something that he wasn't getting. Yeah. So I'd be like, I'm taking Nick's card. Like, whatever this one was, I want that one.
At one point, I kept losing because I forgot to try and get points. I just wanted the cards where I got the throw.
To make a burrito fight, Yeah, that was interesting because the first game, Shane was not feeding me cards. He was like really thinking it out instead of kind of moving along.
Once I figured out the strategy, I got a little better. I finally won at the end, but it took me like 6 games to
actually. Yeah, and that was the biggest problem I had.
We played 2 rounds, so I guess we played 3 games, right? Because we played 6 total rounds.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, the biggest problem I had was the same thing. I wasn't getting points with the animals. I just wanted to fight.
I just wanted people to throw burritos at each other.
Exactly, yeah.
I mean, we only played it 3 times. I don't know if... Because there was rounds where, like, I felt like the one game I had like 10 points, and then the next game I had like 1. So I don't know if it's a matter of like what you're looking for or like
inconsistent
cards. Yeah. Like, I don't know, but
I think it's just whoever's feeding you cards is looking for. Because if you're hoarding like a certain card,
what was it, Lucky Ducky or Clucky?
Yeah, Licking Chicken.
I both have 2 of them.
Yeah, and none of us are giving it.
I'm feeding you everything else. We're just going to keep sliding that, passing that line.
RP's quick with the draw, so he kept pegging me with burritos. So I just wanted to be the one
to initiate it.
Yeah, so he couldn't peg me with burritos.
Speaking of like hoarding cards, I kept hoarding... like the brawl ones, the duel ones,
if you got a war one, you had to keep on to it. You couldn't.
Yeah.
Or like I would have been hoarding, like, say I had 2 of the chickens or whatever, and I would pass up like all these other cards, and I wouldn't get that third chicken, but I would have completely just handed Nick 3 points. Like, points.
Oh, absolutely. There was multiple strategy. And I passed 3 sloths.
Yeah, in a row.
Just trying to find the third chicken, and I'm like,
it's the risk it to the it's risk it for the
you
biscuit.
Got a video
mentality.
Of this to post with it, right?
So yeah, absolutely. I have RP and Nick doing
the duel.
A duel. Which
there
is,
was a there
cheek
was
to
a,
cheek.
There was one.
Yep.
Cheek to cheek. It's not the highlight, but in my head, I thought I really had it beat. So we're in this Airbnb, and it was me versus Marvel, and I threw my burrito and missed. So he had the burrito. And I ran, and I dove over the back of the couch, grabbed the cushion, and held it up like a shield. Like, very Captain America
swift move. It was impressive.
And then was like, but I was on the floor now, like, pinned. And I was like, oh, my God, that was so cool. I'm not going to lose. And then Marvel just,
Bryan just
waited for me to, like, move and then just gently tossed the burrito at me like, you idiot. You
I wanted to see
anyway.
How far you'd flail
I flailed for a while, too. Like, I was a salmon, and you were a grizzly bear. And it wasn't happening for me.
It was too bad because it was a really smooth. It was like if Cap, like, dove on the shield and picked it up. Movement. He was just standing over like, you fucking idiot.
Just why, and I was just like, well, I just gotta wait till he peeks out.
Yeah, exactly. That's all.
Literally just drop it on him.
Much like Nick in a lot of the duels, where Nick would go towards the hallway and you would try to evade him, but then he would just be standing there waiting to peg you with the burrito.
Yeah.
Nick doesn't fall for any bullshit, I guess.
It brought back a lot of childhood, like, me and my brother playing dodgeball in the house with things that weren't dodgeball.
That's exactly what it reminded me of. Like, when someone, like, flipped over the couch, I thought of, like,
it's like
you're playing, like not let the balloon touch the ground.
Exactly.
Kind of, like, feeling,
just
like
those dumb games that you play as a kid that are just like, hey, like whatever this is. Yeah, exactly. Me and my brother used to play soccer, full-on soccer, in our living room.
Yeah, everyone.
We didn't have goals. The one goal was, like, underneath the piano. Like, if you could hit that, like, area.
Has anybody ever used that piano?
It's gone. But
it's a hockey goal.
Yeah, it's a hockey goal.
My mom bought it. It was weird. My mom bought it because, like, my sister played when she was like six. My mom bought it after the fact. Like, and then we had one, and then we got rid of it. And my mom bought it again when my sister went to college. Like, we had that was really late. Like, I don't know why we had that piano. So, like,
an
that,
expensive memento. It's to remember.
So
her
now that I said my sister went to college, so spoiler, this soccer game took place when I was 17 years old. But, like, same thing. Like, yeah. And then the other goal was, like, the kitchen. And we'd, like, dribble around mm-hmm. each other with, like, a dog toy. Like, none of it was ever, like, meant to be what it was. And they clearly were like, yeah, this stuff's fun. Let's make a game out of it.
That's exactly what it is. And it's, I think this is also one of those games that is the audience. This game could be really boring if you're playing. Yeah,
like a bunch of like tight, like,
or like just if they're not diving, like we're literally diving under the table.
Around, you're just like picking it up and just like gently tossing it. Like, the next
imagine we weren't throwing the burritos as hard as we possibly could.
I literally went to my like, I'm having a lot of fun with this, but like, would I want to buy this for my niece and nephew? I'm like, but I wouldn't be as enjoyable. I pegged Bob like
but
not
you could
looking.
Destroy your niece and nephew.
Yeah, like that's not as fun.
Yeah, if you
with a no look. Like toss that went right into my eye.
If you don't like your family, this is a great game.
If you're all over a certain age and there's alcohol involved, great
imagine
time.
Imagine Bryan
with
playing with your niece and nephew, just diving all over the ground.
Oh, I would destroy them. When I worked at a school, we after school program, and we would play dodgeball. And if they were softballs, I'd be wailing them.
Skins.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah,
I loved it. I did the
like
same
Billy
thing.
Billy Madison.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Big trouble.
So, yeah, I mean, I was surprised at this game. I think it was really enjoyable. I got it for Christmas. I mean, I think it goes for $25, but
you
I've seen it cheaper.
Up earlier, it was like $25.
Yeah, I've seen it cheaper. It dropped down to like $12 right before the holidays. I've seen it.
They might have done like a
like a Black Friday, but I've seen it cheap go on sale before. So
I think it's probably like if you have the right group.
It's a
25 is very
it's a good point.
Like, oh yeah, that's price. Replayable.
If you can get it for 12, that's a steal.
I know they
like,
made.
I know it's marketed probably more of kids. Like,
I don't think so.
The
I don't
Scrubs
know.
Podcast does it a lot, and he talks like they used to talk about Donald Faison would talk about how like his kids love that game.
Yeah, really.
Yeah, I guess kids. I think it's more fun if you're old enough to hurt somebody.
Exactly.
Burrito.
So, like, but also, I don't know if that
tell
was.
Tell us more, Shane.
Who hurt you?
Dude. RP hurt me a lot.
I don't know.
He was whipping that thing at me.
That was just like
all love. All
the
love.
Situation on the podcast where like he talked about his kids a lot. So
yeah,
he was like bringing
I mean,
into
yeah,
the
I
advertisement
think
or like
it could definitely be a good kids game as well.
How many hits we did end up having turned into just like a light.
Oh yeah,
wow,
yeah.
Lot.
That's
and even
the best
hard
ones.
Ones didn't hurt that like.
Well,
you're not going to be
the hardest hits we were getting was if they threw it at you and missed. And like you had
you had to roll
it was given.
To get
you
it.
Were gonna hit them, so you would just come peg it at them as hard as you possibly could.
Yeah, so that's throw burrito. I think it's a surprising hit. Our other game, which was not a hit for RP.
Should I check out? Though? Yeah. I did with the game.
So the other game we played today was Betrayal at House on a Haunted Hill, which I think is from I want to say Avalon Hill.
You know what? I want RP's.
Oh yeah.
Wait. So were you really that bored, or did you just really need a coffee at that point?
Yeah. Hold on. Hold on. What's your initial thoughts on?
So I have no idea what the heck was going on with that game.
I think that was the biggest problem. Yeah.
Zero, and then I was tired, and we gotta admit, you gotta understand, people. You guys know how I am. We've been here. We were up late last night. I didn't sleep great last night into this morning. We were up at 7:30. It's just we were at a high with Throw Burrito and literally went directly to this long out dream where we got up. I was relaxed, popping out all the pieces, and then there's like a 16-page booklet you got to read to get through the game. And I was like, I don't care at all. And Shane, Bob and Bryan were having a great
and
time. And Nick.
I was these cards, and
until he
no
died.
One was, like, paying attention to me.
So I was like, okay.
Well, every card Nick got
was a novel.
Six pages long.
So I was like, okay, this game probably won't take, like, it'll probably take, like, 40 minutes. Fine. We got to the 45-minute mark, and I started looking up articles on my phone about other things that interest me because I was so bored.
Yeah.
Because I had no idea. It was my own fault. I had no idea what
was
going on.
Which inherently made the game longer because
I was
involved in it.
And then the end game was like another 45 minutes where we had to separate and read a booklet of 16,000 different scenarios.
To his credit, he could have sabotaged us and just made himself lose. But
he hung in there.
Yeah, and I kept saying, like, look, keep trying. You guys could tell. Bryan could tell about 10 minutes into the game. He's like, you're not feeling it. You tuned out.
Yeah.
And that's fine. Whatever. That's just, but I kept saying, you guys are into this. This is great. Let me know what I need to do to help you guys win.
At the end, I was like rolling for him. Like,
Well, at the end, me and Nick just sat to the side and we're doing a podcast for previously recorded. And I was just like, look, you tell me what you need to do so that our team can win. That's all. Just tell me. Because like, you guys are enjoying it.
We did win.
You did win. I'm not going to ruin it for other people because I'm just not into it.
Yeah.
But I got to a point where I could not wait for this game to be over. And I think it's just.
You weren't feeling it.
I just wasn't feeling
it. I think another day, another try.
We all said, like, after the fact, it was, like RP said, a big high-low.
Mm-hmm.
Like, we went from a very fast pace through a third burrito to a very, like...
Like a mind burner.
Was looking forward to it. We've played Thanos Rising again. I was looking at something like that's kind of quick. The Funko verse. I was looking for something like that, but this was just a slow.
We did
burn.
Get hit with a lot of rules right away too.
Yeah,
yeah.
Another day where you weren't as tired and you were more into like a longer game. I think you would like it more.
Yeah,
yeah.
So let's kind of go over the gameplay. So Betrayal at House on Haunted Hills, like basically a role playing game. Where you and the other players are exploring a house. And it's one of those games where as you're going through the house, you're building the mansion. So you start in like the foyer, and then your little characters have movement, might, stamina.
Stamina and knowledge.
Yeah. So your move is how many places you can move throughout the building. So as you're moving, you're flipping over tiles that are rooms or hallways of the house. As you're going through, you're collecting items, you're doing omens and events. So each tile, or almost every tile, has a little icon on the side in a corner, and that's the card that you draw. You read the card, and that's pretty much it. If you have an item, it's an item gun
tells you what's going on.
It kind of aids you. Yeah. So it's very straightforward in the beginning. So in the beginning, you're building the house, you're exploring the house, raising your might, you're getting knowledge, you're getting items, weird stuff's happening throughout the house.
So every omen card that you get at the bottom says, like, roll for a haunt.
Mm-hmm.
And so depending on how many omen cards were out on the table, you rolled all the die, which I think was 8 total die. And they have blanks. They're weird die. So they're like blank faces. Ones and twos. That's the most that they have on them. And so if you rolled less than the amount of omen cards that were showing, the haunt began. So there was 5 of us, and we weren't really getting a lot of omen cards in the beginning. So I think that allowed us to kind of explore the house a lot. But once the haunt begins, it's almost like a second game with the board
that's
that
almost
you've
the real
created.
Game. Yeah. Like that's almost
you build your board. And then you figure out what your game is.
Yeah, and then the fun begins.
Yeah.
So I will say, like, I was into it prior because I was developing my character. I gave him a few.
He did have an accent.
Oh, we did have some accents.
His accent changed
your character.
A lot.
What
was your character's name?
So originally, it was Professor Longfellow. So I decided to make him Southern. And I was like,
I thought Longfellow was more.
Hold on, let him.
This was Professor Longfellow. It keeps going like Southern British. I can't control it. So then Bob was like, "Well, shouldn't it be?" I feel like he's British. I was like, "All right, let me." This is Professor Longfellow. And then we were reading his hobbies and his traits, and he liked Gaelic music. So we're like, "Oh, we should make it Irish." And so we made it Irish. And he really liked the potatoes. He wasn't a fan of the famine and like all that stuff. And I was really, 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 really into it. And then
he tuned out.
Once accents didn't matter anymore, he was like, this game kind of sucks.
Once I couldn't manage that for like the entire game, I tried saying like, move me 3 paces. And like it went from like Australia.
At one point he was Australian a little bit.
That was such a seamless
British to Irish
transition.
So
that was so good.
It was impressive.
British and Irish listeners, let us know.
That was so good.
Our international listeners.
For us Indians, that seems really like a great transition that he just
is. I'm good at it.
Yeah, so
I can't hold it. That's all.
So once we get all the omens, and as Bob said, you roll the die and you roll less than the omens that are on the table, the haunt activates. So how you Find the Haunt is actually really cool.
It's like a chart, right?
It's a whole chart in the instruction book, and you go what room you're in and what item that you drew, and then it's like a little cross section, and it tells you who's the traitor. And there's 50 different scenarios in the game.
We got lucky because Marvel was the one who drew the Haunt.
And I became the traitor.
All the stuff that would have been complicated, he was in charge of.
Yeah, so, like I say, do a little chart. It tells you who's the traitor, if there is one. Sometimes there's no traitor at all. And we played it for a while before Noman popped off, but it's been played before where it's real quick. Like, sometimes it can activate almost immediately, and it's...
Is there another game that's similar to this? As far as, like, building the house? I feel like I've played something like this before.
I can't think of one off the top of my head, but they're absolutely similar. Off the top of my head, I can't think of one, but there absolutely is similar types of games.
The comic book store, I've seen you guys playing, like, the zombie tile game, where it's very familiar.
Zombies.
Yeah.
Which, so we played that in the comic
book
store?
We played this at the comic book store. Okay, yeah.
I thought I'd played something similar to that.
So, our scenario was, our end game was I was a traitor, so the rest of you guys had to team off. You get two different books. There's a book for the traitor. There's a book for...
This was cool.
That's
like,
what I mean.
This is when RP was out at that point.
You already know what was happening.
That was my problem. I didn't understand what was happening, so I was mad at myself.
And also, I was explaining what was happening, and I didn't understand. To be honest, we had to go regroup. And I'd be like, I messed that up.
He was fighting to stay awake too.
So at that point, like, RP had something where it would help us win.
Mm-hmm.
And so the first time around, he tried to use it, and it didn't work. And then it was like you just saw him tap out.
I also had the sun
in my eyes. Like,
I think if we would have took a break and went and got coffee, I think you would have been more into it.
I don't think so.
I don't know.
Maybe. So
I think if we would have took a break, went home, tried it in 3 weeks, I might have been into it.
Yeah, maybe. We'll try again. So that was kind of good and kind of bad that I was the traitor, because you were asking me questions, and we don't know each other's information. So there was sometimes you were asking me
and
something.
Also, like, I at the end, I showed you the book, and some of that information
I was still reading it. Yeah, it's
like I didn't understand. Like, we had to roll a certain amount of times. And, like, it didn't designate when we were allowed to roll, so mm-hmm. we just assumed we could roll it whenever. That might be wrong.
Yeah,
I don't know. You know what I mean? Like,
so
the
scenario we encountered was that my character found a guy in the house, and he turned out to be a madman, or at least that's what everyone thought. And then he just starts screaming about creatures being outside. And the fog that was outside apparently turned into spirits.
Spectres.
He just started yelling, like, open the windows. So, like, I guess, become mad with him. And I run around the house trying to open the windows. So, on each tile, there's, like, a overhead view of a house, like, room. So, in the ones that had a window in the tile, I would put, like, the specter token upside down. And my goal was to run around, open the windows, let these specters in, and then to kill everyone else. Like, me, the madman, and the specters...
Kill everybody.
Just start going through the house. I open the windows. The spirits attack everyone else.
And then our goal was to do a exorcism.
So we had to get, like, certain keys.
We had to go to certain rooms. So there was, like, a chapel, a crypt, like, mm-hmm. basically, like, religious.
Your
like,
goal
things that you would think
was
about with
to
exorcist.
Save me.
Yeah.
Yeah. Or there were certain items that you could use.
Yeah, RP had a ring.
Yeah. What did you end up getting? Do you remember what that was called?
The holy something.
Holy symbol, I think it was just called. The holy symbol. Like, if you had a certain item, it didn't matter what room you were in. You could try to perform the exorcism. And you had just to roll a certain amount on your one category. I think it was stamina. You had mm-hmm. to roll a certain amount of stamina or knowledge. It was both, like, the mind category.
Sanity, not stamina.
Sanity, not stamina. So basically, it was like it was a race for us to get to these rooms or get these items, which we lucked out. We had them mm-hmm. already. And then roll these things, and it was a race for Marvel to get to this box and kill us.
We kind of had all the items we needed to
help
us.
We got the help, especially considering, like,
because my character's sanity and knowledge was awful, but I had items.
You were like a meathead.
Yeah,
you had more physical
Shane
traits.
Shane had like a meathead.
I had items that boosted both
of
them.
Nick, you kind
of
had a meathead.
It gave
too,
me extra.
He was a child.
Five terrible rolls, so I was already lowered to begin with. Well, Shane's character was Jack Monterey.
Jack Monterey, yeah.
Ox Monterey in this game. It was Jack's brother.
The might was way up, but everything else was
low. He was literally a meathead. Like, just was super strong.
He's super strong and dumb. That's a brick.
so it was interesting. Like, I liked...
I think even though it wasn't for me today, I found this game very interesting.
Yeah.
I think if we had more time and you could play again, like, fresh, I think you would be in.
There was a lot of moving parts.
The idea that there's 50 different outcomes.
Yeah you could. And that's the thing. The replayability is...
And that's what we talk about all the time.
Is replayability. So next time we play, someone else could be the traitor with the same scenario. It could be a totally different scenario.
Yeah.
Like, so that's interesting. Like, if you can... get a group that actually wants to play, then
it's a I'll say this. It's a commitment because especially like
it did take us like an hour.
If we played it again,
it was the longest game.
We would know, like, other than RP, who tuned out right away. Most of us would know what was going on in the game. But like
the first part, for sure, you would know to explore
that,
the house.
That learning phase is extensive.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and if you're not into it, you're not into it.
You know, what I think might have helped. If it was, what's the name of the game? Betrayal of the Sanctum Sanctorum on the Hill, I think.
Or if it was like Disney.
It was Doctor Strange or Betrayal at the Magic Kingdom.
Yep.
If the point of the game was to save the Scarlet Witch, RP would have been so into it.
I would have been the hero.
So they do have an IP, but it's Dungeons & Dragons.
That's so cool.
But just, like it's... It's like Betrayal of Baldur's Gate or something. It's the same idea, it's in the Dungeons & Dragons world.
The game's cool. The gameplay was cool. Mm-hmm. My mentality was just
I think it's complicated.
I think it's relatable if you're like you're here on what we're here doing on our creative retreat.
It's really not that complicated because technically Shane's
up front.
Shane's a gateway gamer and he was into it. Like
it's a lot to learn up front.
I had Bob on my team explaining
it.
Ended up being the traitor, I would have been really lost.
I may as well have had headphones in. That's really it's my own fault.
Well, you were fighting to stay awake the whole time.
You're fighting your own spirits.
I was fighting to stay awake and fighting.
Although there's a creature here, and I think he kind of took over for you for a little bit. You were going his way.
Lenny Kravitz.
The second half of the game, I definitely felt like I was trying to get really into it, but I was just in like the worst possible.
Nick did what he had to do for the team.
He was surrounded by specters.
So every time I was like, oh man, I'm starting to get into this. Like I found like a pathway, a plan to do, and then next turn, I'm like, oh no. I'm like, just two or three rounds from being knocked out.
He got backed into a corner.
We needed four of these tokens for the exorcism, and we sent Nick to the one room where you could get one. And that's where
there was like five windows.
He laid all his traps. Yeah.
So go here. Nick did his job, and then everybody attacked him. And I was just like, Nick, you're dead now, man. Like he ended up getting out, but like in the moment, I was like, all right, you did your job, man. You're dead. Thank you. Do what you got to do now.
That was the most interesting part, was because this could have played out a lot different. So we pretty much used every house tile.
I think there was like three left.
Yeah, like the house was built, so I had all the windows available. Where if I didn't, I would have to search the house for the rest of the windows. So because I knew where all the specters and how
but
windows
same
were,
situation, we would have had to search the house for that. I think there was like five different rooms.
Well, he had RP
and
had the
two
ring.
Items. He had the ring to start. It was like the crypt, the library.
But if he
like,
had the ring and was beating me, actually rolling well, he could just banish all the ghosts.
But it would have been RP chasing all of them and us three just running around like idiots. You know what I mean? Like it would have been
Nick
on him.
Good IP for this game, Scooby Doo.
They have it, actually. I forgot.
Scooby-Doo is the IP for
this
game.
They do have
the
Scooby-Doo version.
Is that the Scooby-Doo game? That you said
is
not worth it?
No, that's...
Scooby-Doo is the
IP. It's not worth it for us. So
fit this game perfectly.
I think they do have...
I'm sure they do.
Scooby-Doo version. It's more like a kid's.
Yeah, but, that's the move. You're
but,
right.
Yeah, another surprisingly... I mean, I enjoy this game. I played it before. I got it for Christmas, finally. It's a game I've wanted, and I just never bit the bullet on
it. How many... Like, what's minimum player situation, two?
Minimum story, I think.
Three. I was like, two is, like, not enough.
Yeah, because it's got to be one person turning on the rest. It's got
to
be at least
three. Yeah, I think it's, like, 3 to 6.
So it's not, like, would you play this versus, you can't play it versus yourself either.
No, not that I know. There's no solo.
Yeah, because you got to strategize, because if you know your strategy.
So, like, how often do you think you'll play this now that you have it?
Not a lot. And that's why I never bit the bullet on it. Yeah, I prefer more solo or two-player games.
Did somebody buy that for you?
Yeah, I got it for Christmas, so... Yeah. We need a Pollyanna, and I'm just like, you know what? Let me throw this on.
Yeah, here's an easy one. Yeah. You're good.
And if I get it, I get it.
Well, I know one person who is willing to play this whenever you want, and it's RP.
Mm-hmm.
Call
him up. We're going to get it to try again. Because we've talked about this before with, like, on Funfair.
Yeah.
Where maybe we just weren't in the spirit of it, because I've replayed it and enjoyed it.
Same thing, yeah.
And it's Smash Up, I think, was just kind of like...
Smash Up was the same effect as this, not Funfair. Funfair was just a while, but I did like it,
yeah.
Kind of.
Smash Up, you had a bad...
Yeah, you had a bad
combat
draw.
I was just so
yeah.
Over it.
Like, because you couldn't do anything in Smash yep. Up. We were just destroying you. In
so I think when we revisit Smash Up, you'll have a different opinion, and we revisit this game. You'll yeah. have, hopefully, a different opinion. Mm. And if not, maybe it's just not for you.
I think there's also situations where, like, in my experience, you don't play. Like, it happened to me at the comic book store a lot, where I'd, like, come in and the game was already started, so obviously mm-hmm. I'm not playing, but We used to hang out for, like, hours at a time. So I'd watch people play the game, and I'd get invested just, like, being invested
yeah,
in what they're doing.
Being an audience
member. And then you're good. Like, that's almost sometimes, like, it's more of a draw. Like, I think that's how I got into Smash Up. I don't think I played the first round. I think you and Duke and somebody else were probably playing. I was like, all right, what is this? And you explained it. And I was like, all right, I can
lot.
Get into this.
Yeah.
So speaking of, like, replaying and stuff like that, we've revisited Thanos Rising this week.
Mm-hmm.
So I've talked about on this podcast how Shane and Nick were newly introduced to the game. So I've spoken for you, but now that you've played it a second time, what are your thoughts on this game? To our listeners out there, you guys are gateway gamers. What's your thoughts?
That game is so frustrating because it's stacked against you the whole time.
Yes.
That it makes you want to keep playing until you win.
What's the fun?
Which I haven't yet.
Mm-hmm.
Now, the fun part about it is that both of you and Nick have texted me like days and weeks later being like...
Just thinking about it.
Nick was like, I'm dreaming about being...
I couldn't wait to get down here this weekend and play.
Yeah.
Like, I was genuinely upset like a few days ago. Like, I can't believe like I lost the game
so
and had no possibly idea.
So Nick texted me and was like, I understand why that game's like, why games are addicting after playing that.
I think part of the problem is you're not losing to like I'm not losing to Nick.
No,
I'm losing to the game, which is like
it's
so
like,
much
together. It's like the reason I don't like gambling is because I'm losing, and the casino is winning when I'm losing. It's Thanos.
It's
Thanos
like the bad guy wins.
Yeah.
That's a great game, though.
It's so fun, but it's so frustrating.
So we said, because I think Bryan already said we're in Ocean City, New Jersey, if we beat Thanos this weekend, I'm going
or
into
London,
the ocean.
Yeah. And we're only like one block away.
I didn't bring bathing suit. Sorry,
I got
short. Yeah, I'll go in.
You're
I'll
not
go in. So if we beat Thanos and you also get, like, there's an in memoriam section because Bob had hypothermia, like, that's why.
It is quite cold.
I'm in. I'll go in the ocean if we beat Thanos.
If you go in the ocean, I'll be there waiting with a warm hug.
I appreciate that.
We'll nurse you back to life.
And a small towel.
Yeah. Yeah, towels here are tiny.
Is it washcloth?
So I had the same effect when I first got the game. Like, I was playing a solo, but you just play with, like, two people.
You played wrong for, like, a month.
Right? Well, I played wrong for a while, and that was frustrating. But once I, like, figured it out, I was still losing. And it was legit, like, every night I was
sometimes
playing
Sometimes we
game.
Even cheat and still lose.
Yeah. This is the game I cheat at the most.
Yeah.
Where I'm like,
we'll re-roll.
What's one more roll?
Yeah. And he still wins.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Thanos Rising is the one game that I will say more than anything else has so much to do with the shuffling of the cards.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. It's if you get
because
a bunch of villains
up
front.
A good, like, sequence of cards, we're like, all right, we've built a team. Now here's one little villain here.
Yeah.
Here's one little villain here. Here's, like, a strong villain. But it's the only one out there, so we can all attack them.
Yeah.
Like, it's just, it's so...
If the shuffle goes the other way and you have mostly villains coming up,
so
you're not
shuffles.
Winning.
Yeah.
You're not going to win.
You're at the mercy of the cards.
Yeah.
And then the dice. It's the most luck-heavy game.
You're at
game.
The mercy of Thanos.
Oh, yeah, and that.
It's true. It is Thanos' game. He is rising.
Yeah.
Such a fun game that I hate playing because it really just drives me nuts.
So we lost last night. This is a 2.5-day retreat.
Yeah.
So we'll play again tonight. And if we lose again tonight, I don't think we can leave tomorrow until we yeah. And I will
extend it another day.
I'll message the Airbnb host and tell him otherwise.
Yeah. You contact him to come up and
help out.
How good are you at dice rolling?
If you can help us win, we'll leave.
It's on the OP's
dime. Listen, everything's clean and taken care of. We're just sitting around your counter playing this game.
Playing this one game. We're on our way. Well, I mean, that's kind of it. We're excited for the new episodes as we kind of have been brainstorming some ideas coming up. Yep. We just wanted to record a little something while we were all together, and it worked out.
If I have the time, I'd love to come play another game and do another episode.
This is a one-time thing.
Yeah, you guys, I appreciate it, but...
No, of course, you're always welcome.
No, yeah, for sure. We definitely have a couple games that are more than two players that we... Would absolutely.
I mean, maybe
need.
When we revisit this, we're gonna need three people.
Yeah, true.
In any of those games, do I get to throw foam burritos at you?
Yeah, we can review. What's the expansion for throw avocado?
Hush, hush, avocado.
Yeah.
chuck guacamole.
There you go.
chop
are they
guacamole.
Are they more baseball shaped? Because I feel like we could really huck them at each other.
No, they're just as they look like half. If you cut avocado,
I actually suggested because there was five of us and two burritos. I was like, I might buy this just so we can play it with four burritos.
More burritos.
In play.
It would be
I think
dangerous.
Like, the more burritos in play is the funner.
Yeah, I might get this for next weekend. I'm going away with Audrey's family up to.
You could borrow it. Just borrow it. I don't care. Yeah. All right.
I'll borrow it.
No, never
mind. buy it. Buy it for yourself. Own it.
All right. But anything to plug before we go, producer Nick, you're the head producer here at the Previously Recorded Network, responsible for this getaway. Anything to plug before we go?
Well, way to put that on the record. I'm responsible.
You are responsible. You're the producer.
He's funding this
I'm
whole trip.
I'm a finance year. That's all I was. Yeah, that's all I was in this process.
I don't have anything to plug. I'm just enjoying a nice weekend.
Mango Kart.
Mario Kart? Yes, good
Mario
one.
Kart.
Yeah, get a Switch. They're awesome.
All right, Shane, that's your plug. Bob,
can we plug other podcasts?
No, wait. Since this is Gateway Gamers.
No,
all right,
never mind.
I'll tell you what Shane is not a Gateway Gamer for. Mario Kart Deluxe on the Switch because he's apparently played it nonstop for the last 6 weeks.
Yeah.
Because nobody was within a lap of him yesterday.
it was impressive.
Bobby,
the drifts were tasty.
I'm good. I'm good.
All right, well, I'm going to plug as always, Previously Recorded. Check it out. And also check out our merch. Check out our Gateway Gamers merch. Check out our Previously Recorded merch. The last couple episodes, I've been plugging it incorrectly. It's like redbubble.com/people/prevrec/shop, I think is what it is. Or check it out. The link's in the bottom.
I mean, if you just search.
I really got to fix those. I really got to fix those show notes.
On Redbubble, look out for personalized merch for some of your favorite podcast hosts.
Yeah. Marvel, anything to plug before we go?
No, that's it. Like always, thank you everybody for listening. Thank you, Previously Recorded friends, for being here.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Thanks, Lenny Kravitz.
Yeah. Bye-bye. Let's go.